Rome has invited the African Artist Foundation for a collaborative presentation in our project space, Foam3H, for which we're presenting the work of three young, talented African photographers. It is the second in a series of collaborative projects here at Foam, for which we invited photography platforms from Indonesia, Nigeria and Mexico to co-curate a space here at Foam. This allows Foam the opportunity to exhibit different photographers, young talent from different cultural contexts, and research international developments in photography worldwide. We're very pleased to have collaborated with Azu Wagbogu, who co-curated the space with us.
The African Artist Foundation is perhaps famous in these parts for organizing and presenting the Lagos Photo Festival. And it's a festival of photography that happens for about a month in Lagos, in Nigeria. And for whatever reason, we've had a wonderful Dutch presence from inception. So there's always been that sort of partnership between the Netherlands and Lagos in that sense, or the Netherlands and Nigeria, or Lagos and Amsterdam. And I'm really glad that Foam is able to host what I feel will be the next generation of talent on that qualitative level in this wonderful space.
We are very proud for this exhibition to present the work of three very young, very talented photographers from Africa, namely Muchiri Njenga, who's from Kenya, Osborne Macharia, who's also from Kenya, and Kadara Anyasi from Nigeria. All three photographers present kind of fantastical, futuristic worlds in which it's very hard to see where fiction begins and reality ends.
A lot of times people have a lot of association with Africa that is unreal or biased in a certain tendentious manner that does not really reflect the young energy, the future, the hope and the aspirations of the people. We've curated a selection of artists who are viciously unsatisfied or dissatisfied with their contemporary reality and exploring reality for the future. So whether it's issues of gender or sexuality, like in Kadara Nyasi's work, or the marginalized people in society, as Osborne Macharia shows in his own work, or in Bob Muchiri Njenga's video, where he really explores what he calls or what is understood to be transhumanism, a sort of futuristic representation of technology and mankind in creating another universe, if you like. I think this exhibition will shock a lot of people and will surprise a lot of people because it's really fresh and it explores new ideas. I would suggest that if you observe a lot of reflection on contemporary photography from Africa, it's always about the extremes. So it's very reactive. And photography is reactive in a sense. So a lot of the work that you'd see would be work that is sort of countering the prevalent narrative that is about death, deprivation, disease, poverty, and all of that stuff. And then you see the extremes. But what we have here is more nuanced. So you do not hide away from the sociopolitical, but you present it in a way that is more interesting and more engaging, that even allows for more of an intervention, more understanding. If you think about the dominant documentary narrative, it hasn't really improved or illuminated contemporary reality in Africa. But when we explore fictional narratives, we can create and find more emotional truths in there. And I think that's really the beauty of this exhibition.